must be there. You go to the budget and open up the budget documents. It says one page would be budget in the synopsis or something. There, you look at the expenditure. It will be in lakh crores, you know, lakhs, maybe 1.5 lakh, two lakh crores or something like that. You just look at the breakdown. Subsidy. That's an expenditure. Then interest payments on past loans, expenditure. Then defense, expenditure. Government salaries, expenditure. Transfer to states as grants, expenditure. Like that, you'll have about 6-7 items. You total them up, and you'll find that these 5-6 important items will add up to 98% of the revenue that you get. That is, that amount will equal 98% of your revenue. The expenditure on these would be 98% revenue. Now, tell me, which of these items I can prune? I heard somebody whisper, but not loud enough. Oh, come on, don't be afraid. This is one of the problems with Indian students. Subsidies. You are not going to be a politician, I can tell you that. No politician in India will dare to touch subsidies. You lose the election. This is why Narasimha Rao gave you from 0% growth rate to 7% growth rate. When your average for previous 40 years, 45 years was communists to hide shame said it's a Hindu rate of growth. What Hindus have got to do with it? It's a Soviet rate of growth, you know. But anyway, 3.5, and what happened to the election? He lost it. Why did he lose it? Because the Western interests who had grown over the Soviet period, those license and quota touts, you know, and brokers and so on, they found this deregulation is drying up their money. So they said, my God, this man continues, we are all finished. Had no clue what is happening for them. So in fact, an intelligent politician would design his economic reforms so that some things come right away. For instance, if I were in charge, I would say, and I had told Narasimha Rao, he didn't agree with me, I said, abolish income tax. Immediately the middle class will be happy and they will all cheer, and the stock market will go up and so on, and you'll only lose 4-5% of your revenue. You'll make it up, let's print notes 4-5%. And that money that goes into investment will increase growth. Growth will raise indirect taxes, and indirect taxes will be more than what you have lost by abolishing income tax. Do something directly, or have a linking of rivers project so that digging starts and all the farmers, the rural area workers, they all start getting some employment. So they see something new is happening. You must always do something which is immediate results. You see. You know, this, if this kind of thing you do, then people will be supportive. But if you just say, no, I'm deregulating, and then, you know, it's slowly over a period of time, I'll filter down. Obviously, the rich people who have capital are going to be benefited first. So therefore, the budgetary collapse, I can't touch defense. I can't touch police. Is there anyone who would like to cut police expenditure now? After Bombay, nobody would dare. Nobody will touch defense. Nobody will, you can't touch interest. You have to pay. That's statutory. Otherwise, you'll be defaulting. You can't touch subsidies because, oh, everybody will be up in arms. You lose the election. So what can you touch? You can't touch anything. So 98% of your revenue is gone. What do you do for investment? Borrow. From whom? Your own banks. Force them. Tighten, twist their arms. Buy government treasury bonds. And that's what the banks have been doing. 50% of the bank's loanable funds have gone to the government. And so the government has been managing. But there is a problem there. You have to pay back that money. It belongs to the bank. Anyway, you know, the depositors or can create problems for you if you don't. So you have to pay that. Now we find that for every rupee that the government is borrowing, it is paying 97 paisa back as past loans. And by 2011, it will be 1 rupee, 1 paisa for every rupee you are going to borrow. So what are you going to do? You will have to say ultimately, I can't pay salaries, or I will put aside a salary in a fixed compulsory.